What's up, athletes? You're here because you believe that you can max your potential on the tennis court with the law of success, learn, apply, and win. Now, in this video, we're gonna be covering what the role of the core and your arm action is in generating power in the modern forehand kinetic chain. Now, here's what you probably think when it comes to the forehand kinetic chain. Your forehand starts from the ground up. Your hips must fire first because this initiates the rest of your body to rotate forward. And your arms, well, your arms are completely relaxed and your core, your torso, is responsible for generating all the power in your forehand. But what if I told you that this way of thinking is completely backward? That instead, there's a better way that could guarantee you the ability to time your forehand kinetic chain and, of course, get you more power. Let's go. The common belief is that the hips fire first, initiating your upper body to fling forward. And this is 100% scientifically backed. According to a study performed by biomechanist Landlinger et al., in high performance tennis players, the hips are the first to fire, and that there is a delay between when your hips and trunk rotate forward. In part one of this forehand series, I explained that your muscles are like rubber bands. The more you stretch a rubber band, the more potential energy you build and the faster it'll shoot forward. The delay between your hips and trunk creates a similar stretch. Milliseconds later, your upper torso slings forward with extreme force. The trunk muscles involved in your acceleration forward include muscles such as your obliques, back extensors, and erector spinae. So then what could possibly be wrong with thinking about accelerating forward, starting from your hips? To answer that, let's first take a look at the modern forehand arm action. How relaxed should your arm and your wrist be in the modern forehand? Most coaches and players talk about having a relaxed arm and wrist in the forehand. I even talk about this in our wrist action video. Keeping your arm loose is important in achieving that wrist lag position and generating maximum racket speed. And so you might think that your arms should not be generating any force and that they should only be carried around by your torso rotation. Anything besides that would be arming the ball, right? What if I said that this thinking is in fact harming your forehand? Because let's say your opponent hits the ball, you move to it, prepare by loading, and then relax. Well, if you're too relaxed, your legs would collapse and your racket would fall out of your hand. Of course, on the other hand, if you put all your muscle power into blasting your forehands with your arms, you'll end up generating less power too. So then where's the fine line between controlling your racket or generating force and being relaxed? Well, when in doubt, let's look at the science. According to a study by Rafael E. Bahamonde, high-level forehands include horizontal shoulder adduction, meaning players are deliberately bringing their arm forward to generate racket head speed. And you can see this in pro players too. If Taylor Fritz here wasn't deliberately bringing his arm forward, the angle of his shoulder flexion would not change so much from the start of his forward swing to contact. So how does this all tie back to the question, how can you time your hip and shoulder rotation? Well, if the pros are consciously accelerating their hitting arm forward to hit the ball, there has to be some degree of independent movement in their upper body. Meaning, just by focusing on your hip and core rotation, everything in your stroke won't just fall into place. So what should you focus on to unlock the final bits of the kinetic chain? Well, to really fully grasp the answer and understand everything that goes into developing your forehand, the truth is, there are a lot more factors that come into play in terms of getting power on your forehand, like your grip, your backswing, your stance, the optimal contact point, and even your follow through. So go subscribe right now, click the bell notification button, because you're gonna start seeing some really, really awesome content. What should you focus on to unlock the final bits of your kinetic chain? There are many different ways to think about your acceleration in the modern forehand. Some coaches will recommend that you focus on your hitting arm shoulder, Other coaches will tell you to focus on keeping both hands together. And then some coaches will tell you to focus on pulling your hand forward. One thing's for sure though, if you focus on your hips to start your forward rotation, you'll feel difficulty in timing your forward rotation, and you'll over-rotate in your shots, and you'll lack consistency. And the reason why there's so much diversity in these teachings is because they all work. So athletes, you've learned. Now comment below how you're gonna apply this so that you can win. And while you're at it, let me know, what videos do you wanna see next? Until next time, guys, go out and train hard. See you in the next video.